Okay. I can make an omelet that tastes like it has cheese in it, but with no cheese.
You want to know something, Shepard?
Yeah.
I've never actually committed, what's it called again? What are we doing here?
What do you mean, what are we doing? Isn't it obvious what we're doing?
Yeah, I know what we're doing. I just don't know why we did it.
Well, it's called burglary.
Burglary?
Yeah, that's what I said.
I'm pretty sure what we just did here is called home invasion and assault.
Are you serious?
I'm pretty sure.
No, stop saying that. What do you mean pretty sure? Pretty sure means you're 50-50 on something. You're telling me you're half confident on something
well,
that...
I'm sure.
Okay, well, no. Burglary is illegally entering someone's building without using too much force. I mean, we just snuck in here so quietly and undetected that I could hear that weird, high-pitched ringing in my ears.
Without too much force, does it say that in the dictionary? I'm pretty sure we just snuck in here and knocked this guy out with a good amount of force.
So we just committed burglary and assault.
Yeah, I've never actually known anyone who's done that.
Well, chances are, if you know anyone in this town, you've known someone who's done worse. I'm gonna go get my money.
Alright, cool. Wait, what? Why is your money here?
Eric, I found this. I don't know what this is, but it shaved off some of my hair. I mean, it looks pretty good. Anyway, look what I found.
Wait, why are you taking extra stuff? Are you getting greedy?
Just look at it, man.
Was that?
Yeah.
Does that mean
we
need to take this?
Mm-hmm.
And bury it in the desert where no one will be able to find it.
What?
Did you not see
that? Yeah, I know what's in there, but some other guy's gonna dig it up, mess around with it, and then leave it on the beach for someone even dumber to find years later. Alright? Now it's safe.
With you.
Yes.
You know how in TV shows and movies and video games and books, a character can make a seemingly great choice and everything just starts to resolve itself?
Yeah, that's right now.
But you still have that feeling inside of you that something is gonna go wrong anyways? That's right now.
Oh, come on.
If you went through all that trouble for whatever reason, just for a small pocket of cash, how easy would it be to just sell that thing to a museum and make a boatload?
What? That's weird, man.
What? Everything to you is weird. Everything normal to you is weird. Like, you should sell an ancient artifact to a museum and make a lot of money. That's freaking weird, dude. An omelet without cheese in it isn't gonna taste like it has cheese in it. Whoa, what is this guy, an alien?
I bet you I can blow one person's mind who eats my omelet by telling them that it has no cheese.
Yeah, okay, so what do you want to bet?
$1,000.
You don't even have $1,000.
$100.
You owe me $100.
Okay, what about a dare?
Yeah, sure, whatever. I don't care because I'm going to win anyways.
Okay, what if the loser has to say, my feces is green and it shouldn't be that way. I should go see a doctor. No matter where they are, they have to say that.
Sure, in any situation. I'll say it in front of a church. So, why did we just sneak into a guy's home, knock him out, and then steal something that could probably get us in a lot of trouble?
Eric, when I told you that we were gonna go steal something, you didn't even care what it was. You just wanted something to do.
No, I just assumed that that guy deserved whatever he had coming to him. You know, I assumed that you wanted to settle the score for something he did, so what did he do?
Well, for example, if you go to the movie theater to watch a movie that's being marketed as a revenge thriller sort of thing, what do you think you're gonna expect?
What?
You're just waiting for something bad to happen to motivate the hero of the story.
What are we talking about?
Hold on. That's the part that people want to get to when they're watching a movie. I mean, if you go watch a movie, you don't care about the main character's family or belongings because you know that sooner or later, he's going to lose one of them and then the movie's going to start. It's just a device to get the story going. And so it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter that he beat me up or he stole from me. The bottom line is, I got revenge and that's that. End of story.
Well, a whole new one is going to start unless you get rid of that book. And I don't think you're gonna like how it ends. And plus, if the revenge movie we're talking about is an actual good one, like The Count of Monte Cristo, then I would be told the reasoning behind the generic revenge plot.
Alright. Here's the story.
So I'm out on a nickin' spree, you know? A muggin' run. I'm the Rob. And I have so much money in my pants, I'm looking like MC Hammer with those parachute pants he wore back in the 90s. I'm feeling like a kid on Halloween. My bag is almost full and I'm about to call it a day, but I'm still like, I can still get candy from one more house.
Wait, what? Are you talking about trick-or-treating or mugging people?
Okay, well, I'm comparing getting candy on Halloween to stealing people's money.
Don't... Okay, just get to the point of the story.
Okay, so...
I'm power walking down the street like I'm a world-class criminal. I see this guy just minding his own business, just chilling. But I don't see a guy. I see another pocket full of cash, and it's like a ghost town of crime around here, so I gotta take all I can get. I stroll up to him like I'm going to grab a pint of milk from the store, and I'm like, hey, you better know where you're at, sir, because I'm taking everything but your life. So he turns around, and before he can even take a breath, I put my Nerf gun...
My shotgun?
Right in his face.
Wait, did you just say Nerf gun?
Okay, I don't own a gun, okay? It was fake.
And I know immediately this dude isn't having any of it. He's like, you better walk away, punk, or you'll open a door you'll never close. Did I hear you right? Everything in your pockets right now! But I can see that none of this is fazing him. It's like he's been in every war in history, or what? I'll feel the sting of a rubber dart hitting my face. I'm starting to panic, so I come at him with the old reliable, what's more important to you, your money or your life? And in the back of my mind, I'm still thinking, no. Then he pulls out some bad poetry crap and he's like, guys like you are a dime a dozen, and I'm worth far more than a dozen dimes. And I'm like, what? Before I know it, this dude is beating the crap out of me. He's like, you're gonna send a message for me, punk. Whatever that means. I wake up like 10 minutes later, and not only has Al Pacino disappeared, but all the money I got from robbing people too.
That is so stupid.
I know. I should have at least bought a BB gun.
No. I just don't comprehend how some of the most obvious things do not resonate with you. You should not be robbing everyone in the neighborhood.
Well, you gotta respect the hustle, man.
You really just said that?
Well, I gotta take all I can get. You know, I'm never gonna be capable enough to make a fortune and become a bounty hunter and do big jobs like I'm...
Boba Fett?
No, like a more realistic bounty hunter, like, Django.
From Django Unchained?
No, from Star Wars.
Django was not the bounty hunter. He was the partner of Christoph Waltz, who was the bounty hunter.
He became a bounty hunter at the end, didn't he? There's a lot of badass characters, like, Bossk, the cool lizard guy.
From Star Wars.
Come on, man. Oh, hey, I... snagged this from that guy's bathroom. You want a Pez?
Yeah, thanks. Shepard! What are you doing, dude?
Considering our last expedition, it's nothing unusual.
What is it now?
Well, if you look right there, on the street, there is a considerable amount of guys with body armor carrying automatic weapons right outside our house. I don't
any idea on what they want?
Well, if I knew that, I would have brought out a megaphone by now for negotiation. No, I don't.
You don't think that this has anything to do with that freaky book you stole?
We stole. Okay, don't try to pin this on me. That's not going to solve anything. No, they're probably part of some criminal organization or branch of the government or...
How do you know, just by looking at them, that they're all criminals or part of the government?
Look at them. Look at the way they're standing. The way they act. I mean, they look like they're the most important people in the world. They came pulling in here in black SUVs, tailgating like wolves.
Well, yeah, and everyone's wearing sunglasses. Well, everyone except for that guy.
That guy.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Oh, no, 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 no. This is bad. This is really bad. Oh, no.
What is so special about that guy?
That guy. That's the guy we stole the book from.
You recognize me?
Yeah, we had an altercation a while back.
That's right. So, if I left with all that money, and I took your Nerf gun too, why do you think I'm here now?
From where I'm sitting, I don't know.
Look, we're not all stand-up citizens here. We've all had our fingerprints and mugshots taken.
Well, maybe you guys have had some history with that, but I've stayed out of that life.
No. You're a shoplifter. We are all people living outside the law. But you know what I have that you don't?
Money?
Guns?
Connections. When you're someone like me, who has connections like I do, it's only a matter of when you'll have people involved with the police, and soon have access to all the data in the police department. You ever heard of the phrase, never work with the same people twice?
No, I haven't.
Well, you just messed up. Because even though I found your fingerprints at my house, pretty obvious you were there too.
Look. All we took from your house was some money that he wanted. Okay, that's all we left with.
Hey, I could stuff you in a trunk, tie you in a pretzel, and throw you off an overpass. You're not in a position to be lying to me.
Yeah, we were in your house, but the only reason we broke in is because you stole my money.
Your money? Oh, so you mean the combined pocket change of everyone you robbed in that area? Yeah, you didn't lose nothing. Hey, yo, give me that omelet over there.
But that's my omelet.
Whoa! I'm the guy with the gun, you're the guy with the omelet, and in about 5 seconds, I should have... You know, you're not the first sloppy hotshot burglar who thought they had the perfect plan to steal one of my artifacts and thought they wouldn't be on the run for the rest of their life from me. You know what we do to guys like you? Wait, is there cheese in this?
No.
How is there no cheese in this?
It's a French omelet.
Okay, so the thing we do to guys like you... Okay, no, how is there no cheese in this? Huh? Like, look, if you held this gun in my head and you said, tell me there's no cheese, I couldn't do it. Hey, are you guys leaving me out or something? Are you gonna tell me what a French omelet is?
We had a bet.
Yeah? What was the bet?
Well... The bet was that I could blow one person's mind.
My feces is green, and it shouldn't be that way. I should see a doctor.
Okay. Both of you, shut up! Shut up! I got 12 dozen men guarding this house right now, and they are expecting me to come out of that door with an artifact in my hands. So either you give it to me, or they're gonna be paying a visit inside.
Wait, you said you want what?
The artifact!
Wait, the artifact, what is that supposed to mean?
The book, man, the book.
Oh, you want the book.
No, I asked because I thought it'd be frickin' funny. Give me the book right now!
It's in the box under the table, okay? Just stop freaking out over a piece of literature!
Yeah, it's in the box. Here, let me just pick it up for you.
I don't see this artifact in 5 seconds. I'm gonna turn you both into pincushions. 5, 4, 3, 2.
What do you think? You really think I'm feeling like a Pez right now?
No, don't give me that. I mean, I was just trying to ease the tension, and you didn't make it easier ratting us out by thinking that the book was in the wooden box.
Well, wasn't it? Wouldn't everything have just gone smoothly if we gave it to him?
No, and no.
Are you serious?
You think I would keep anything as priceless as this anywhere but right on me?
Get rid of the book, Shepard! Only bad things have happened to us since we stole it!
I mean, except for you losing the omelet bet.
While we were at gunpoint.
Yeah, I didn't forget. It was like 10 minutes ago.
5.
Next time I talk about how my feces is green, you try to stay serious. I know what I'm doing.
You know what you're doing.
Yes!
You don't know anything! Okay? You went and stuck up a crime boss for your hustle! Right? You know, I always almost get killed because of these stupid things. It's never something I plan. You know, it's always something stupid. The run from a crime boss with a magic book on our hands.
You two. You two must be feeling pretty great about yourselves right now. Hell, even I'd feel great about myself at this point.
There are men on all the roofs in the neighborhood. The ground team is already moving up behind you guys. So, I want that book on the ground, or you'll be on the ground with it.
I'll destroy it, okay? If I see one red dot on my forehead, I'll open this up and rip out every single page that I can. Do you really think that their aim is good enough to not hit the book?
We know you're not in the mood to waste bullets tonight.
Hold your fire! Hold your fire! Alright, take the shot!
Stars glow above. Don't.